what stayed the end. What became of him framed it again. Yeah, me? Now? What is up, internet? Welcome to the hottest show on YouTube, Talking Mayhem Mania. I'm your pal in the mainstream media, and hey, Mayhem Mania is back. It's year four, and joining me across the vast interwebs is Mad Mike from Poughkeepsie, New York. What's up, Mad Mike?
Oh, I'm so glad. This is my favorite time of year, Matt Carlins.
It's my favorite time of the year, too. Long nights, long Tuesday nights for me before I go into work. Hurt feelings, convoluted rules. Best time of the year. I love it. I look forward to it. Don't you? Hey, So we made 8 matches from scratch tonight. Next week, the real hurt feelings begin. But Mad Mike, you seem to, you created Chris Jericho versus EC3. We all love new toys. And
yes.
It's great to have EC3 in the fold for Mayhem Mania. So many possibilities. Especially with Drake Maverick now in the mix as well. but you seem to have gotten tripped up later on in Mayhem Mania once the issue of Samoa Joe came up. So I must inquire, what did you have planned for Samoa Joe?
I didn't have anything planned for Samoa Joe per se. I was just curious as to his status.
So however, were inquiring for later rounds, perhaps.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. However, I didn't know Daniel Bryan was in play.
Oh, yeah.
Well, and that, if I had known Daniel Bryan was in play, I would have made Daniel Bryan versus The Miz.
Now, let me just go back over the ruling on Daniel Bryan, because
yes.
we have this discussion every year, and every year we have to have, we always get new information. But, the bottom line for me on Daniel Bryan is that, and the basic rules for Mayhem Mania is that we have to operate within the current reality. We have to run our thing by the same rules as Vince McMahon. Daniel Bryan has told everyone with a set of ears that he can wrestle. He says there are doctors who will let him wrestle. It just isn't the doctors that work for WWE. So in my mind, if Vince McMahon felt like, God damn it, I gotta have Daniel Bryan on this card so that we can sell 18 million more WWE network subscriptions, then he would find a way to make that happen. So in my mind, that means that Daniel Bryan is definitely allowed in the game this year. So I don't think there's any argument against it. And he did get used. He got put into a 4-way. I can't believe we were asked about Daniel Bryan, but not asked if William Regal was okay. That was just thrown out there and just slipped right through. But Daniel Bryan versus Kurt Angle versus William Regal versus Drake Maverick in the general manager 4-way. That's pretty spectacular.
Can we call that match General Mania?
General Mania. I do kind of like that. That's pretty good. I just wanted to say also, I had I came in knowing that I was gonna probably have to create a match tonight. It's always important to come in with at least 2 or 3 ideas, because I had a match for Aleister Black that was gonna kick ass, and it got taken away from me right off the drop by Bobby FJ Town. But I can't blame him for using Aleister Black, because he's awesome.
Do you want to reveal who you had in mind for Mr. Black, or are you saving that for maybe somewhere down the line?
I'm going to save it, because I want to see if someone else comes up with it. Because to me, it's an awesome matchup that I am... It's actually the first match I thought of when I thought about Mayhem Mania this year. I spend a lot of time thinking about Aleister Black because he's kind of my boy right now. I also had a really good idea for the revival that I didn't get to exploit, but that's okay. We'll save that for later, too. Hey, let me ask you a quick question, Mad Mike. New guy Jay here was on the show. He had never seen Mayhem Mania before, I don't think. And he just kind of got dropped into the fire, and he had to come up with a match. He came up with Lars Sullivan versus Lashley. What do you think about that first effort? That's pretty good for a rookie.
That's a pretty solid start. Coming hot out of the gate using a rookie and a veteran. We love the rookie veteran matchups here at Mayhem Mania, and Lars and Lashley. That would be an ass kicker of a time.
The field of talent for Mayhem Mania has never been this deep. I can't wait to see what someone comes up with for Ricochet. Rey Mysterio is back in play again. My God, Adam Cole is... Oh, yeah, he's totally in play. Absolutely. He showed up once, he can show up again. The possibilities are endless. We got a ruling on Joe. It looks like Joe will be ready for Mania, so I think, we can let people use Joe. I mean, Oh my God, it's all out there, man. It's gonna be awesome.
And War Machine. Let us not forget War Machine.
Yep. I mean, like I said, we just keep like Candice LeRae's in the mix. I mean, we could find a match for her, right? Surely we can get her to do something.
I have a question.
Yo,
I have a question, Matt.
Yeah.
Are intergender matches in the mix?
Yeah, I think so. Because hey, if Vince thought he could make money putting an intergender match on WrestleMania, he would do it. So, I think that's totally cool. Yeah.
I'm throwing out questions here because, you know, there are a lot of people who probably haven't seen Mayhem Mania before. They want to get the gist. They want to, you know, these are the questions of the people, Matt Carlins.
Yeah, I know. I really am making it up as I go along, but that will become more apparent as we go along. No, there are rules, Sorg. Don't shake your head at me. There are long, long, long list of rules that I must now go through before we begin the next round next week when we bring in some five people and they're going to be able to start making changes to the card, and we'll see which of these matches is able to survive 3 weeks without being altered in any way, because then they will graduate, they will get locked in and advance to the super card, and that will open another slot for us to play with. It's going to be a blast. Mad Mike from Poughkeepsie, New York, thank you very much for joining us on Talking Mayhem Mania.
My pleasure as always, Matt Carlins. Always here to help put the younger guys over.
That's right. It's always good to see you putting the young guys over. hey, if you have a suggestion, if you think one of these matches sucks, feel free to tell us, comment below. Go to WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Check out our cool write-up. We'll probably have some badass graphics courtesy of Antonio Garza or Alex Garza, one of those other talented guys.
And Garza, we must again, Scott Dawson. Front and center.
Scott Dawson, front and center. Do not anger that man. FTR
you
forever.
You should not even see anything below Bobby Fish's chin.
He should be at least three times the size of Bobby Fish. At least three times the size, right? Yes. I thought so. I thought you'd agree with me. At least five times the size of Bobby Fish. Bobby Fish should probably be shrunken down, and Scott Dawson just to take up his space. That should probably
He's a little fish in a big graphic.
He's a little fish in a big revival. So thank you very much for joining us, Mad Mike. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week for more exciting action and hurt feelings on Talking Mayhem Mania. Good night.
This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.